All right, hands up. Who's still using 5.8? Okay, and a follow-up question. Who's still writing 5.8 even though they're using something newer? Okay, so I fall into the former category because Amazon's production tool is still 5.8. 5.8, in fact, for reasons known only to people I don't know. So since I'm sort of currently touting around a CV that says Modern Pearl, I think I'm able to catch up on what I've missed. CV available from that man over there, and probably various other people as well. So here are some of the edited highlights of Pearl Delta for the last 9 versions. Warnings. These are edited highlights. If I missed your favourite feature, I'm sorry. Secondly, just because something appears in one version, don't go, but it's not valid anymore, because I haven't got to the version where it gets just unvalid. And thirdly, I only have 15 minutes for 9 major... Actually, that's now 14 minutes, isn't it? Okay, let's go. 5.10. What do we get in 5.10? We've got use feature, which allows you to turn on various old bits of the software, or off to taste. Also comes with nice things like feature bundles, so you can say, use feature colon 5.10, you get all the 5.10 features. If you want to do it from the command line, there's minus E, which turns on all your features for that version. So, we also have the defined OR operator. For all those times where you've been writing stuff like that, you can now write that without fear of being mugged at for referencing undefined variables, etc., etc., etc.
We might need to be using $A.
Sorry?
We might need to be using $A as a variable.
Well, I cut and pasted out of the release logs. What can I say? Some things obviously happened on that day.
We're going to retroactively edit the Pearl Delta for that.
We have say, which bizarrely is still an experimental feature.
It's not experimental.
It's still a turn-onable feature, even now, which is print for those people who can't bother to write back, type backslash in. We have this lot. Of which more later. About the only fun thing to note is that Smart Match is actually quite cute. In that notionally, it takes the left-hand side and right-hand side and matches them in some intelligent manner. In 5.10, this was a commutative operation. In 5.10, onwards, it decided to be completely crap-fueled and insane, so it was fixed to be not. So, for example, array Smart Match subroutine now does something sensible, namely, passes if the subroutine returns true for all values of the array. The other way around is perhaps not so interesting. We also have state. State is the first of the where have you been all my life features. For those who haven't spotted, figured it out yet, state is a stateful variable. Stateful of, well, it's my except the value does not go away. That initializer will get ignored next time into the sum. And the value of whatever you've done in your dot 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 will persist. So if I've ignored it a couple of times, next time I put it through, it will have the value too. This is handy. I like this one. Where was it when I needed it? What else have we got? Lexical dollar underscore. That's another of which the less said the better. watch this space. And a decade's worth of fixes and tweaks, because this is 5.10, which is the spiritual successor to 5.8, and it took about 10 years to get there. Which is part of the reason I suspect why an awful lot of people are stuck on 5.8, because they never made the change. On to 5.12. Package name version. For all those times when you wanted to write package tech to our version, it couldn't be bothered with all that character garbage, you can now do it like that, which is nice syntactic sugar kind of thing that should have been in there all along. We have the yada yada operator. Pretty much does what it says. You can replace a piece of code with dot dot dot. It will compile. It will, however, exception if you try and run it. This is occasionally handy. What else have we got? We have anything. If you start doing the used version of Pearl construct after I think 11, the last pre-release of 5.11, that does an implicit use strict, so you don't have to remember to do it, which is kind of handy. Next up. Why 2.0.3.8 compliance? To quote the release notes, you won't care much about these. This, the kids will thank you. pluggable keywords. I think I could best sum this up by pasting the contents of the tail end of the documentation file for Goosex Declare. Fundamentally, Devil Declare is crap. Even MST admits they will declare retroactive. You should know as an expert on these kind of things. In 5.12, with a little bit of expansions further into 5.14, this goal has been achieved, and there are now mechanisms to magnetophil keywords without having to take hallucinogenic drugs to understand why they fail. End result of this, MUSEX declared, which is I love it, is no more, and there are better theoretical ways of doing that kind of thing, and other things that fiddle with Perl to add more keywords. Use feature Unicode strings. We start the slow march towards completely invalidating my 30-minute rant on Unicode. This allows some of the built-in functions like UC and LC to have Unicode semantics, i.e. set the UTF-8 flag on the string and behave properly when you use them on strings with ASCII strings with code points in the top 1 to 8. More of this later. There'll be a lot of these. what else have we got? Now, you're going to start to see a pattern very soon, and there are a couple of things that happen in every Perl release. We bump the version of Unicode, and as a side effect, we make bucket loads of changes to regexps. I'll gloss over those. If you really want to know, read the Perl Delta for the appropriate version. On 5.14, use feature Unicode strings. At this point, my talk on my rant on Unicode is reduced to 3 slides, namely encode on the way in, decode on the way in, encode on the way out. Everything, if you turn that feature on, the mad insanity of using native ASCII strings if you can stay within 1, 2, 5, 6 characters stops happening, and everything is Unicode, and your hair stays the colour darker than mine. Another nice bit of syntactic sugar, you can now, that's the equivalent of writing open block, package foo, closed block. It's just pretty. Array and hash container functions accept references. What were they thinking? For all those people who are too lazy to dereference the hash ref before they do the push, we added push $array ref. This is quite a fun one. If you're habitually using something like SRAND to signal your tests to generate run a random subset of your tests, you can now get SRAND to tell you what its seed was, so that when your tests fail, you can rerun it and feed SRAND the seed it used without having to spend your time figuring out how to make relatively random seeds. So it's quite a handy one. File handle methods load IO file on demand. Basically, this means if you do something like that, then there's an implicit load of IO file happens to cause bin mode method to work. Again, quite handy. Localizing a tide variable and ties it. I'm not quite sure why necessarily something you want to do a lot, but fundamentally, as soon as you do the local, that becomes untied. Fun. Unicode, see the pattern here, Unicode 6. Yet more regex fixes. On 5.16. It's got a fun one. __sub__ is now a reference to the current sub. If you're doing really hairy recursion, this might be useful, I suppose. Interesting things start being removed from core, Cplan Plus, if anybody still uses it, and Devel Deprof. If you're not using Devel MIT Prof, why not? Unicode 6.1. Sorry, regex fixes. You get the idea. That was quite a. There's a few other odds and sorts of that. That was quite a short one. 5.18 is where the fun starts. Hash randomization. You can no longer rely on the order of things returned from a hash. You can set various global variables to make it go back to the old behavior, but under normal circumstances, your hash, the return, the order of things you get back from keys, will not be guaranteed. If this breaks your code, you do it wrong in the first place.
It was never guaranteed. It's happened to most of the time in the same moderation before.
But that's what's supposed to happen. Lexical subs. Which is nice. You can now go state sub foo, my sub bar, our sub. State sub and my sub are functionally identical, except when you want to use closures, you have to use my. And state is slightly quicker. This does allow you to do with the nice package stuff we had earlier. You can now do something like this. And presto, you can't actually get a foo underscore bar foo. The interesting thing is you can't actually get a sticker within the class as a method accessor actually either. You have to call it directly, which is probably a good thing. It makes sure you think. Kill minus name now works properly. This is a good one. I haven't spotted this one. Negative signals kill the process group. If you do it by number, it's fine. Up until 518, if you did it by name, it was kill minus zero, I think, or something strange. Anyway, it didn't work. It now does. The encoding module is removed, and one of the lovely little gems hiding in the routers, broken as designed and beyond repair. Switch given and when are now experimental. Thank God, I think is probably the best thing we can say there. And I do have a note of what was said here. It is clear that smart matches are almost certainly either going to change or go in the future. Relying on its current behaviour is not recommended. Warnings will ensue. Well, actually, warnings will ensue unless you use no warnings experimental smart match, which is also added in 5.18. No warnings experimental :: feature will stop it warning if you're using an experimental feature. Lexical $_. It's now experimental. Since it was introduced, it has caused much confusion with no obvious resolution. Fine. Here we go again. And here we go again. 520. Subroutine signatures. Ooh, shiny. does pretty much what you expect. It's not apparently equivalent to doing this using shift _, but hey, it's still there. Rand is now Perl's own built-in random number generator on all platforms. However, and it says this very clearly, this does not make it cryptographically secure. End quote. We have key value slices, which means you can now do something like that, which is kind of cute, I suppose. We have postfix dereferencing, which, okay, if you want to, I suppose. I'm sure there's reason for it. The end of an era. CGI is finally not a core module, and neither is module build, thank God. Unicode 6.3. The old regex fix, wow. 522. What have we got at 522? A double bind operator. So alcohol really for jokes there for those of us old enough. It's like the diamond operator for opening all the files on IPv, except it uses three arg opens, so you can't persuade about the pipe and other things like that. Aliasing via reference. No more faffing around blobs to do this. Essentially, that does what you expect. It makes C, $C, shadow, $D. Which one of the nicer uses, so you've got an array of hashes, you can alias the hash and then start playing around with it, and it is a genuine alias. What else have we got? Use RE strict, make sure your regex cars are somewhat stricter. Hex floating point literals. Now there's a thing I never thought I'd see. Yes, you can write hex floating point literals if you've got reason to do so. Close now sets dollar bang. This one amused me. Apparently didn't used to. Who knew? This one just made me die laughing. For those familiar with EBCDIC, there are some interesting breaks in EBCDIC encoding. IMJ are 7 code points apart. So if you write, I'll show you the release notes. If you write that, Perl has to do a little bit of internal magic to ensure that you only get two characters out of the deal. However, this was completely broken if you use the Unicode names for the characters. It's now fixed. Aren't we all glad for that? Unicode 7. An interesting change to regex. \x\x is now deprecated, which means nothing to most people because apparently it's trawled through CBAN, found no instances of it. Blazed through the last two versions. Somebody finally realised that was a bad idea. Somebody finally realised that was a bad idea. read the release notes. Postfix dereferencing is no longer experimental, though I still have no reason to use it. And we have Unicode 8, which leaves, finally, 5.2.6, the latest and greatest. \8x in regex basically allows you to use white space inside character sequences, which makes your code in theory makes your character seem to be more readable. Lexical sub is no longer experimental. Indented here docs. I'll be waiting for this one because I hate it when my code looks ugly. This tilde here basically allows you to do an indent on your here docs so it matches up the rest of your indents, but doesn't add the indent when you, which is kind of lovely, really. This one's a doozy. God knows what that's going to break, but unless you take steps to stop Perl doing it, it no longer has dot in that ink. So things like building unit tests and the like need to be a little bit more careful. Unicode 9. Wow. And you must, there was a couple of versions earlier, you should escape literal open curly brackets and break apps. You now have to.
Unless you're new or something.
Yep. That is, with about a minute to spare, the whistle-top tour of what's happened since Perl 5.8. I commend you to Perl.Perl of Index History, and if you want to see what each of the features do, Perl.feature. Thank you very much.